Beautiful. I want to ask you, Dr. Joe, if there's one person out there struggling, living in depression, living in hopelessness and anger and desperation, if you could just say something to them, what would it be?
Well, I would say to them that those emotions have a very, very significant effect on their bodies, and that the only person they're hurting when they live by those emotions is the actually themselves. And so they can come up with a lot of reasons why they are that way, but the bottom line is that the emotion is still in them. And if they could begin to ask themselves a couple questions in the morning, what would I have to change about myself to be in joy? Who would I have to forgive? What would I have to let go of? And as they began to answer those questions, they would begin the unlearning process. And then I would ask them to begin to give thanks for the things that they find in their life that are precious or important to them, and begin to not have it be an intellectual process, but actually have it be a very physiological process to feel that. That's when we begin to free the body, you know, from our own chains of emotions.
And what about that person who is just saying, you know, I've lived through hell, born under a bad sign, I've had it bad since the day I was born, it's still bad now, it's always going to be bad. Can they, even that person, change?
Well, first of all, you got to want to change. I mean, you can't make a person change, but listen, beliefs, you know, our beliefs are created by our attitudes. Our attitudes are created by how we think and feel. How we think and feel are created from our memories. So we pretty much define reality based on our memories, because those beliefs then form perceptions. So the person who has to have, here's the deal, that person has to be willing to drop their emotional beliefs long enough to allow new information to enter into their mind and body. They got to begin to allow in new thoughts and new knowledge to enter into their brain, because if they don't, you know, for most people that have strong emotional tendencies, no new information can enter into their system that's not equal to the emotion that they're memorized to. So they can't wrap their mind around an alternate possibility, because listen, if you feel it, then it's real. But so then when a person finally reaches the lowest point, and this is what typically happens, that's when they finally realize they got to let go of something, because they've reached their lowest point to realize that they're alone. No one has any answers for them, and it's up to them to begin to change. And unfortunately, the human mechanism is that we reach that low. And so if the person then is able to learn information and they begin to wire it in their brain, you know, every time we learn something, we make a new synaptic connection. So as they begin to learn new information, and as they begin to think about being somebody else, there's a good possibility that they can climb out of the hole if they're willing to take time for themselves to begin the process of change.